Hello children, now we can move on to the second lesson, the Turkish cap. Name of the lesson is the Turkish cap. What do you mean by Turkish cap? A cap made in Turkey. Turkey is the name of a country. Okay, let's meet the characters of the story first. Here, the first character is the author himself. Do you know who is the author of the story? It is B.B. Gupta. The author himself is narrating the story. The story is in first person. The author himself is telling about one of his childhood experiences. Along with the author, his friends are some of his friends. Nilesh, Paresh, Brijesh, Kunal, some children's names are there. Author, his friends, and the school principal of the school is another character. Then a stranger, one passer also is there. These are the characters. So who are the characters? Author, his friends, the school principal, and the stranger. So let's see the outline story first. This story is based on a game named Gilli Danda. The name of the game is Gilli Danda. This is an old version of cricket. I think you all like cricket, you all play cricket. So this one is an old version of cricket. In cricket, we have bat and ball. But here, in this game, instead of bat and ball, we have two pieces of wood. They are called the gilli and danda. Gilli is used instead of ball and danda is used instead of bat. One striker is there, then some fielders are there. The striker stands in the middle of a circle and he places the gilli in the center of the circle. And the fielder stands outside. The striker hits the gilli and the fielder standing outside the circle, they want to catch the gilli. If they fail to catch the gilli, the second chance also goes to the striker. He can play the game. If the fielders caught it, then the person who caught it can. That is the game. So, here B.B. Gupta and his friends were ready to play. After the school time, they took the gilli and danda and went outside the school compound. Their school compound was very small. So, they decided to play outside the school compound. That was a public space. Then, the children took the gilli and danda and they went outside, they started playing. There is an interesting description about their game in the lesson. So when they started, Kunal was the striker. Kunal was an excellent player. He gave strokes. He started hitting the gilli and nobody standing on the other side was able to catch the gilli. Because Kunal was an excellent player, nobody was able to catch the gilli thrown by Kunal. So, once the striker Kunal hit the gilli, it flew outside and all the fielders couldn't catch the gilli. The gilli flew outside and what happened? One person was passing by. I told you it was a public place. One person was walking along in the road and there was a cap on his head. The gilli flew outside and hit on the cap on that person's head and both the gilli and cap fell down. The gilli landed inside the cap. That shows the strike was an excellent one. So this is the first part of our story. And before beginning the story, we will see some new rules. See, strike. here, point a finger at a textbook and move along with my reading. The school bell rang. We rushed out of the classroom. I took the guinea out of my bag and Kunal took the dhal. We reached the ground outside our school compound where we usually played. So now the school time is over. The children went outside, rushed outside to play. They have Gilly and Danda inside their bag. And they ran to play outside the school compound. Parish drew a big circle. Kunal entered the circle, placed the Gilly in the center, and took the Danda to strike it. The others took their positions around the circle. So I told you, one side the finger is there, and on the other side the striker's circle. Say, now all are ready to play. The others took their positions around the circle. They are fielders. Kunal struck the gilly hard. It flew out of the circle and went quite far. None of us could catch it. So Kunal, the striker, started hitting the gilly, and the fielder standing outside tried to catch it, but nobody was able to catch it. Nilesh was the first to reach the gilly. Picking it up, he threw it back at Kunal with all his strength. Kunal struck hard again. The gilly went flying in another direction. Kunal was proving to be too good a player for us. So, as I told you, the striker Kunal, he hit the gilly again. And the children standing on the fielder's side, they are Nilesh, Paresh, so many other children are there. They all were unable to catch the gilly. The gilly had flown over to Pramod. Pramod flung the gilly back at Kunal. Kunal hit it again, this time towards Brijesh. It should have been an easy catch, but Brijesh missed. Disappointed with himself, Brijesh tossed the gilly back at Kunal with all his power. Kunal didn't miss this time either. So second and third time, every time Kunal proved himself as an excellent striker. Nobody standing on the other side could catch this gilly. Now it is the fourth time. The gilly was now flying towards me. Me? What's other? Now the gilly was flying towards BP Gupta. I was ready to catch.